Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. My today's recipe is a tangy fish curry, and for the fish today I'm going to use basa, but you can use any kind of boneless fish for this recipe. So without any delays, let's have a look at the ingredients now. My first ingredient is of course basa fillets. Here I have around a kilo of basa fillets which I have cut it into half. My next ingredient is onion paste. Here I have around 1.5 medium sized onions which I have pureed it. Here I have 2 tablespoons of tomato paste which I have diluted it with some water, but if you want you can make tomato puree at home with 2 medium sized tomatoes. 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste, 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of fenugreek seed or methi seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of fennel seeds, and 2 dry red chilies. Here I have 1 whole garlic which I have crushed it slightly, a few curry leaves and 4 green chilies. For the powder masalas, I have 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 2 tablespoons of coriander powder, 2 tablespoons of red chili powder, and 2 tablespoons of cumin powder. And our final ingredient is tamarind juice. I have used around 3 sticks of dried tamarind which I have soaked in boiling water and taken out the pulp from it. Our pan is hot, and to this I'll add in around 3 tablespoons of white oil. Our oil is hot, and to this I'll add in dry red chilies, mustard seeds, cumin seeds, fenugreek seeds. Do not add too much of fenugreek seeds, it might become bitter, and fennel seeds. My mustard seeds have started crackling. To this I'll add in the slightly crushed garlics, green chilies and curry leaves. I'll just cover it and cook it for 2 minutes so that the garlic starts turning slightly reddish in color. So I'll remove the cover now, and as you can see I have stirred it in between once, and as you can see the garlics have started turning slightly brownish in color. I'll add in my onion paste now. I'll cook my onion paste for a minute or 2 till it slightly turns brownish in color. My onion has been cooking for around 2 minutes now, and to this I'll add in my ginger garlic paste. Tomato paste. Give it a good mix, and I'll cook this till the oil starts separating. So I'll cover it and cook it for another 5 minutes now, or till the oil starts separating from it. Next, I'll add in my dry ingredients, turmeric powder, cumin powder, red chili powder, and coriander powder. Give it a good mix. I'll also add in my tamarind juice now. And some salt. Salt is of course according to taste. Mix it well and cover it and cook it for at least 10 minutes. My spices and vegetables have been cooking for around 10 minutes and have stirred in between once, and you can see the oil has started flowing on top,
Now I'll add in 1 cup of water and my basa fillets. Slightly mix the fish fillets with the gravy and we'll cover it and cook it for 5 minutes now. At this point, you can also check in the seasoning. It's been 5 minutes now and my fish looks cooked. Actually, basa takes very little time to cook, so it is done. But if you are using any other fish, cook it till it is completely done. So I'll just switch off the gas now and serve it. My fish curry is ready and this is best served with some steamed rice. And before ending my video, I would like to mention in this the tamarind juice that we have added, you can increase or decrease the amount according to your taste because some people like it really tangy and others don't. So friends, on that note, I would like to end my video here. Do give it a try and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.